passwords are not really random. So when someone is trying a brute force attack, they don't have to sort of search for things in the dark. What they really, if they're smart, they would start with more popular passwords. So the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5s or password or whatever it is. So you actually can sort of reduce the amount of work that you have to do by trying out more popular passwords first. In fact, what you can do is create what is called a rainbow table, which is nothing but potential passwords and their hash values. And there's a table that you create. Okay, the hash value table for each possible password. And so this is, you don't even have to run your hash function when you're doing this brute force guessing. You're just doing a lookup in a rainbow table saying, this password, let me see what its corresponding hash value is. And does that match some entry in the rainbow table without having to compute the hash function? You can have these other tricks you can use if you're the attacker is use a rainbow table or be smart and try more popular passwords first. A couple of other things related to passwords and their guessing and things like that. We said, what if two users pick the same password? If they're common passwords, then of course 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is picked by lots and lots of users. How do we avoid this problem? In one of the quiz questions, we said, what would happen if the hash value was the same? It's sort of related here. If the two have the same password, they'll have the same hash value. And by looking at the hash values, we can see that from one person's password, we can log in as the other user. And that would be a problem. Fortunately, we have a solution to that. We add a random number before we do the hashing. So we take the password string, add this random salt. The random salt will be different for different users. That makes the hash value different for different users. If two users pick the same password without the salt, their hash value will be the same. But with the salt, their hash value will be different. And we wouldn't know whether the passwords are the same or they're different because the hash values could be different either because of the passwords being different or the salt being different. We'll have to store the salt because later on when we do the check, we're going to get a password. We'll need the salt before we can run the hash again so we can compare it with the hashed value. So we're going to need the salt. Where do you store the salt? You store it in the file where you store the hash value. Whoever has access to the hashed value would also have access to the salt, which is fine, actually not a problem. So this checking when we have salt is done by combining or computing the hash function with both the salt and the password.